Hi there guys, welcome to this lesson. My name's Tom Quayle. Now for this particular lesson today, I'm using the Yamaha THR10 amplifier, and I'm using the Brit High amp model, which is basically a high gain kind of modern sound. I've got a little bit of delay running as well, and then I've got this PRS S2 mirror guitar, and I'm using the bridge pickup, and my tone sounds like this. So, for this lesson, I'm going to show you a really cool way of developing some new ideas within your standard minor pentatonic scale that rely on a technique called hybrid picking. Some of you may have come across this before. Now, our standard kind of line that we're going to use to develop this is a really common thing that people play. And it goes like this. This is the line that we kind of build from. It sounds like this. Now the way I'm playing that line, just in this 5th fret standard minor pentatonic box, is by using hybrid picking. Now you don't need to, but by using hybrid picking you can get a lot quicker. So let me teach you the basic version of the line, then I'm going to show you 3 other lines that incorporate some string skipping to make this more interesting sounding in terms of the intervals. So the actual line, the basic version, goes like this. Okay, that's the basic cell that we're going to move around the guitar. So we start with the little finger on the high E string at the 8th fret, and we're going to do a downstroke and then pull off to the 5th fret to the first finger. Now here comes the hybrid picking section. We go down with the right hand on B8 with the 3rd finger, and the little finger's going to go on high E8, and we actually use the middle finger on the right hand to do an upstroke, a light upstroke, not a big kind of, but just a brush. And then back to B8 with the 3rd finger with a downstroke. So we get... Okay, now we're going to go back to the 1st finger on the high E at the 5th fret and use the middle finger again on the right hand. And then we repeat the phrase down a string pair. So that phrase... Now we repeat that between the B and the G strings, making the notes fit for the minor pentatonic scale. Now between the G and the D. Moving down. Sorry. And then finally the lowest 2 strings, pick, pull off, pick, pull off. So we get this all together. And then a little bit quicker. And the hybrid picking allows us to get that speed there without having to pick between the adjacent strings, which will be much harder. There's less movement involved with the right hand as well. Now that looks fine, except that it's very, very formulaic. So we've heard it a million times before. One more time. We want something slightly more interesting, and we can make it more interesting very easily by skipping a string each time. So the new lick that we're going to do goes like this. Okay, a little bit quicker. One more time. So you can hear that's a much more modern sounding lick. It's got a lot more kind of interest in it because of those wider intervals. And the string skips give us that more modern kind of sound. Okay, so how's this going to work? Well, we start exactly the same way. We're going to start with that little finger at the 8th fret of the E string, and we're going to pick and pull off to the 5th fret. Now the 2nd or 3rd finger, but I recommend the 2nd because we're trying to avoid this pair of fingers, the little and 3rd, as much as possible, is going to go on the 7th fret of the G string. Pick that with a downstroke on the right hand. Then put the little finger back on high E8, and we're going to go middle finger on the right hand. Then we're going to go to the G7 again, do a downstroke. And then we're going to go to E5 and use the middle finger again on the right hand. So. Now that is our cell, so we're then going to move that down through the string set. So. Now I actually facilitate the string change by doing an upstroke at the beginning of each new phrase, but I recommend you start by doing a downstroke, so it would look like this. See that downstroke of the right hand? I'll do that one more time. Watch for the downstroke on the B string. Okay, and again I'm going to do pick, pull off, going to the 8th fret to the 5th fret on the B string. Okay, then my second finger is going to come across to the 7th fret of the D. Then I'm going to use my little finger on the 8th fret of the B again, hybrid pick. Then back down to D7. And then, B5 with the first finger, again, hybrid pick. Now I do the same thing on the next string set, so I'm going to go 7, pull off to 5 on the G. Now I'm going to put my second finger on A7, do a downstroke, middle finger's going to go to the 7th fret, or middle finger on the right hand, sorry, is going to play the 7th fret on the G string, which is fingered with the 3rd finger. Back down to that A7, and then 1st finger on G5, again, hybrid pick. So, now to finish the lick, what we're going to do is this. See the little pull off at the end? So the last one, a little bit more awkward, is going to go 7th fret on the D string, pull off to 5. Then we're going to put the little finger on the 8th fret of the E string, the low E, and we're going to go E8 to D7, back to E8 to D5, and that's hybrid picked. So, and then we're just going to pull off from E8 to E5 to finish the lick. So we get. And that's the whole thing played as one unit. Now, we can move this through our pentatonic scale. So I'm going to do it in position 5, which is this position. Okay, so in this position we get this sound. Okay, a little bit quicker. So that's the sound. Now let's learn how to play it. So we start with either the 3rd or little finger. In my case, I start with the little finger on the 5th fret of the high E string. Pull off to 3 on the same string. Come down to G5, and we're going to go G5, E5, G5, E3. Again, same hybrid picking. Nothing's changed about the pattern. We're then going to move to the B string. Pull off from 5 to 3. Now we're going to go D5, B5, D5, B3. Now on the G string, G5, pull off to G2. All the same picking again. We're going to go A5 to G5, A5 to G2. Now the last one, D5, pull off to D2. Now we're going to go E5, D5, E5, D2. And then pull off from 5 to 3 on the E string. So we get. Again, a little bit quicker. Okay, one more thing I want to show you. I'll just do this really quickly. We're going to do a spread version, so a stretched version of this within the minor pentatonic to get even wider intervals. Now this version, nice and slow, would go like this. And then a little bit quicker. So now we're getting into something really modern, and this is exactly the same pattern, but every note, the highest note on each of the strings, are moving up one diatonic position within the scale, or one scale position. So we now get pull off from 10 to 5 on the E, then we're going to go D7, E10, D7, E5. Now we do exactly the same thing, the same frets, same fingering, everything on the B and the D string. Now on the G and the A strings, we go 9, pull off to 5 on the G, A7, G9, A7, G5. And then finally we get D10, pull off to D5. And this is a little tricky. We get E8, D10, E8, D5. And then pull off from E8 to E5. So. Play that one a little bit quicker and you get this. Very, very cool sound. So there you have it. Hope you enjoyed that, guys. Find it useful and I will see you next time.